Ah, good evening, people. Up in front of the camera today, we've got some little updates with the Fun-Jiggery-Pokery Unit, okay? Now, we've all seen that and what I can get up to with that. But I decided that it's time to upgrade this Fun-Jiggery-Pokery Unit, because I am beginning to find it's a bit too basic for my liking, okay? As you can see, there's a double adapter in there with a plug, a lamp holder, and a light bulb on it, okay? That is because when I use my variac in my bedroom, if I start it up straight on the mains, it makes the circuit breaker pop. Okay, so what I've got to do is I've got to put the variac in there, okay, turn it on, and then once it's started up and got fluxed up, and then take the bypass plug, okay, and put it in there, like that, right, that light bulb would then be bypassed, so what's on there, which would be the variac, gets the full current of what's going in there, okay. But yeah, all this rigmarole and faffing around. So what I want to do, basically, have that out of there. See if I can disconnect it with one hand. Hold on a minute, people. Right, okay, that's out. Now what I would like to do is that socket in the middle there, that one, I would like to whip that off, and in its place I would like to put this. Okay, a double socket, and this one was a bit more, slightly more specialist than the usual ones, because the switches are normally in the middle there, but they've been put to the outside like that. Now the reason why I've opted for one of those sockets with the switches to the outside like that, they are what's called outboard rockers, okay? Normally situated in the middle like that, there. They're to the outside. And the reason why I've opted for one of these sockets is because what you can do sometimes with a double socket is you go to turn this socket on, and as you press the switch, you accidentally press this one as well. Okay? Now, in a situation where I'm doing a bit of Fun-Jiggery-Pokery Unit, if I accidentally activate the other socket, it could result in a few fangs and pops and circuit breakers going off and things. Okay, but with this one, because the switches are spread to the outside, you can only operate one with no accident of operating the other one. Okay, and that's why I've opted for a socket like that. And I would like to put that socket in place there. Okay, and then if I've got to soft start something, I can put the light bulb in that side, like that. Okay, light bulb in that side, and the bypass plug, if I can just move that over to the other side, because that's not going to reach. The bypass plug can go in there, like that. Okay, now with that socket in place, I can turn on that's now on, okay, and that light bulb will be in series with that socket, okay, and I can put something in there and soft start it, and then once that is soft started, I can then just go over to that, press that, and that's the bypass plug in there, and when I press that, those two sockets on there are then bypassed, okay, and then it'll, this one here will get the full current, okay? So it will come in there, into this plug, straight across, back out and into there. Okay? Because that double socket there is going to be where that currently is. I'm going to take this socket off. Okay, we're going to do away with that. So we're going to have an appliance inlet, that double socket with the outboard rockers on it, and then that. Okay, so a little bit later on, it's 5 minutes now, A little bit later on, I am going to have this Fun-Jiggery-Pokery Unit apart. And in order to get that socket in that space, I'm going to have to unscrew this appliance and let it shift it right to the end here. And then that will create enough space on there. That socket may have to be moved along a little bit also. There's a little bit of board there, so I may have to move that socket along a bit so that I can get that double socket in where that normally goes. But I do believe taking measurements of that, the width of that, the width of that, and the width of that coupler, and then the width of that board, and then doing the maths, that I can actually get that socket in where that is and go it from there. But that's what's going to happen with the Fun-Jiggery-Pokery Unit. I'm going to give it an upgrade with a double socket in place of the first socket. And, of course, if I can get that light bulb out, there we go. That socket has got the outboard rockers on it. Okay. It's a bit expensive, that. Well, I paid full price for that as well. Okay. Now, while I've got a bit of time, if you just bear with me, I'm going to get a screwdriver. We're going to open it up and have a look on the back of it. Just bear with me a minute, people. Okay, I'm back, and let's have that socket open, and we'll have a look around the back. Now, the reason why I'm going to open this up so you can have a look on the back, okay, is because one of my subscribers said that basically with an American socket in the USA, you could actually do a Fun-Jiggery-Pokery Unit with one double socket. Now, in the UK, you cannot do that, and I'm about to show you why. So, from what one of my subscribers was saying about doing a Fun-Jiggery-Pokery Unit with one socket, what he's effectively saying is, on an American socket, you basically bring the wire in and it goes to this socket, and then inside there, you then join these sockets together, alright? And then the other cable comes out of this one and carries on down the circuit, okay? But in this one, in the British socket, well, let's have a look. There we go. That's what's inside. Okay, this one's got two earth terminals on it. Okay. The two central earth terminals are in the middle there. I'll see if I can get a zoom on it, but the thing is, you know what this camera's like for zoom, people. Right, there we go, that's zoomed in quite nicely. Central earth terminal's in the middle there. And then we've got the neutral there. And the live there. And as you can see, all of the internal junctioning is done inside there. So when you put a live in there and a neutral in there, and an earth in there, that live, neutral and earth will supply both outlets. Okay, the switches are up the top there, one there and one there. Okay. So there we go, that's how it rocks on the back of a British socket. And it doesn't matter whether they're metal clad ones like this, or domestic plastic ones, a bit like that one up there. Okay. They've all got just three terminals on the back. Or, in the case of this one, it's got the two earth terminals on it. Okay. So there we go. And that's how it works. So there we go. Okay. So, I'm going to get this on upgraded now, and thanks for watching, people.